Hello everyone, welcome to Morning English, this is Cecilia.
Hey guys, 欢迎大家收听早安英文 this is January.
Hey Jane, I'm so excited.
Yeah, what happened? 这么兴奋看起来是有什么好事发生吗
You won't believe it. You know my favorite singer, Tia?
Yeah, she's super talented.
Right, 创作才女 Tia. This weekend, I was watching her Instagram live. She played several of my favorite songs of hers.
Like a live acoustic mini concert? 是不是像一个小型音乐会一样
Yeah, absolutely loved it. You know what the best part is?
Yeah?
So after playing the songs, she stayed on the live for longer to answer some questions, and I submitted mine.
And she picked your question to answer?
Right, and I still couldn't believe it, and I know I need to calm down. 能跟偶像互动的感觉真的是太奇妙了。
I bet. I think she picked your questions to answer is not merely out of luck. It's also because that you know how to ask a good question.
确实啊，会问问题在生活当中还是蛮重要的。
Yeah, knowing how to ask a good question is very practical in communications. It's important to do this the proper way.
没错，特别是在日常交流当中，不少的外国人呢，他会觉得中国人说话或者提问的时候不够礼貌，其实是因为大家没有考虑到英语语境下的沟通技巧。
And different ways of asking questions can help. And knowing how to ask good questions will help you have great conversations.
Right.In today's podcast, we are going to talk about how to ask questions properly.
对，那在今天这期节目当中呢，我们就来聊一聊在英文交流过程当中如何更礼貌地去提问。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Let's start with some common mistakes in English communications.
Sure, 那我们首先来聊聊几个常见的提问方面的错误。
So, Jen, 一般看到朋友或者同事的状态不太好，想要关心别人的时候，你会怎么提问啊？
那用中文的话，肯定就是问，哎，你怎么了？
对，有些人呢，就会把这个问题直接翻译成英文来提问，问成 What's wrong with you? 你怎么了？感觉还挺说得通的。
But it's actually not polite to ask this way.
没错，在问 What's wrong with you 的时候呢，重点是在强调你这个人，也就是问你这个人怎么回事，你这个人是不是有毛病啊？
对，本来是想关心对方，结果表达出来的意思是说对方有毛病，所以呢，显得特别的不礼貌。
So yeah, of course it's not okay to ask this way.
哎，那我们可以怎么样来正确的去表达呢？
我们直接说 what's wrong 就可以了，不要后面的 with you， 这个就可以表达你的一种关心。
Or what's the matter? Everything's alright?
比如说今天上班啊，看到 Jane 闷闷不乐的，就可以问 Hey Jane, you look a bit down, what's wrong? Everything okay?
That's a good example. 那第二个呢，容易常犯的问题，就其实跟问题这个单词相关。
比如说你想问对方你还有什么问题吗，经常就有人会说成是 What's your problem?
What's your problem? 在口语当中呢，其实表达的意思跟 What's wrong with you 是差不多的，也是在说对方有毛病。
对，这里的 problem 就不是提问的问题了，而是表达棘手的毛病。如果你说 What's your problem? 用更加激烈的语气的话呢，听起来就会非常的有敌意了。
What's your problem? So the right way to say it is, Do you have any other questions?
对， question 这个单词呢，才是表达提问的这种问题。
Yeah, so don't make such mistakes when you ask questions like this in your future conversations.
Yeah, so in general conversations, what can we do to make our questions sound more polite?
我觉得这个就需要分情况了。那其实疑问句呢，一般分两种。So the first one is direct questions.
Direct questions 就是直接疑问句。那顾名思义呢，这种问句就是直截了当的提问，不包含任何额外的语言。
对，比如说 Are you single? 你单身吗？或者是问一些信息。For example, 我 What time is it now? 现在几点钟了？
Direct questions are fine when you're talking to your friends or family. 如果是问自己身边比较熟的人、亲朋好友之类的呢，问这种疑问句就是完全没有问题的。
Yeah, and they are also very much appropriate when you pair with the right tone of voice.But how about asking strangers the right questions?
如果是问陌生人的话呢，直接疑问句就可能显得不太礼貌了。For example, if you meet someone and just ask, "Where's the bathroom?" or "Can I use your phone?" it can sound a bit impolite.
对，虽然用这样的问句在句法还有语法上面都没有错误，但如果是问陌生人的话。最好是在提问前加上 excuse me or pardon me, 听起来就会显得礼貌很多。
Here's another tip. 如果是带有 can 的疑问句，如果使用 could 就会显得更加礼貌。
对，比如说刚刚说到的这个例子 ,can I use your phone? 那如果是更礼貌的就可以问成 excuse me, could I use your phone?
对，这样听起来就会更加礼貌一些啊。那另外一种直接疑问句更加礼貌的方式呢，是在问题的末尾加上 please.
Yeah, for example, could you help me please? 请帮我一下好吗？
Or could you pass me the salt please? 能把盐递给我一下好吗？
对，但是呢，我们要注意，并不是所有的句子加上了 please 这个单词之后就礼貌了。比如说 please close the door, 请把门关上。这个听起来就感觉有点像在使唤别人。
对，更礼貌的方式呢是问 Could you please close the door? Or would you mind closing the door?
对，那我们刚刚聊到的呢就是如何让直接疑问句听起来显得更加礼貌一些。
对，说完直接疑问句 Direct questions, 下面肯定就要说 Indirect questions。
对，这是间接疑问句。间接疑问句呢，就是附加补充的语言，使整个问题更加的礼貌。Indirect questions are questions with extra words and phrases to make your question softer and less demanding.
没错，使用间接疑问句是一种特别礼貌的提问方式。间接疑问句以引入性短语开始，比方说 Do you know? Could you tell me? I was wondering, is it possible to?
对，在语法方面呢，我们就要注意，那后面跟着的真正的问题，它是以肯定句的形式呈现的。When you use extra phrases, the rest of your sentence will return to the regular word order of a normal positive sentence.
Yeah, you don't need to switch the subject and the verb like you do when you make a direct questions.
那我们来举几个例子，比如说 Where's the train station?那这句话用更礼貌的间接疑问句来表达的话，就可以说成是 Do you know where the train station is?
Or could you tell me where the train station is?
Or I'm wondering if you know where the train station is.
对，你可以加上各种引入性的短语，使问句听起来更加的礼貌。
Yeah, and here are some more examples of phrases that you can add to a direct question, so that you can transform it to an indirect question. 那我们最后呢，再补充几个常用的间接疑问句引用语吧。
Here I've got, is there any chance, for example, is there any chance we can get the documents sooner? 我们是否可以早点拿到文件呢？
Another one is, I was hoping to know.For example, I was hoping to know if you'll be driving home tonight. 这个就是在问你今天晚上是否会开车回家呢？
And the last one here is, do you have any idea? For example, do you have any idea if she's coming in today? 你知道她今天会来吗？
So these extra phrases quietly ask for the listener's attention before you ask your question. Your listener will feel more respected when you soften your question like this.
对，如果要熟练使用的话呢，还是要多多练习使用。Remember, practice makes perfect.
Yep, don't forget to apply them in your daily conversations.
那我们今天的节目就到这里啦。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Thank you so much for listening. This is Jen.
This is Cecilia. See you next time.
Bye.